Hello guys, welcome to another series of 2JZ Tuesday. My name is Michael Chung, and today I'm going to show you guys some tips and tricks for removing and installing your camshafts and checking for valve clearances. If you guys are new to this channel, please consider to subscribe for more information about engine building and drift analysis too. Here is my intake valve spring retainers and locks. You can see that there looks like a lot of oil. So after clean using degreaser, this is what I get, you see? Oh. Shiny, yeah. You use a valve seal plier so that you can press the valve seal and remove it from the cylinder head. And it requires some force, so we need to press down the cylinder head and wriggle it down. Alright. The valve seal was left quite long ago, so it has deteriorated the rubber. Sometimes we open the valve seal and the valve seal came out, but the rubber is still stuck inside the valve guide. So we need to use something sharp and something curvy so that to pull the rubber out, just like this. It's like repairing a cavity for dentists. Here it is. Hello guys, I'm going to set valve later, so I want to show you guys how I install this cam. So now I'm installing this 2JZ intake cams, intake valves. So I'm going to use this tool. This one is the valve compressor. And then one side I'm going to press on the valve, and the other side I'm going to press on the spring and the retainer. So I'm going to let you guys see up close. Alright, this side I'm going to press this compressor, the spring valve spring compressor, onto the valve. And then this side I'm going to line up with the valve spring and the retainer. Line up properly. Okay, done. Although it seems easy, but actually I've already done a few rough compressing, and then I find the perfect spot for the compression distance. So in this way I'm able to put in the valve locks easier, and then I'll show you later. Alright, I'm going to hold the valve lock. I'm going to hold it at the tip. Okay, just a little bit tip of it. And then I'm going to try to put in into the valve. Okay, I'm going to put in. Let me see the autofocus. I'm going to put in the valve lock. And then I'm going to use my hand to fill it in, and then I try to wriggle the wax spring compressor until it is in. All right, it is in now. So it took some time, but it definitely is a bit troublesome, but managed to put in by just wriggling up and down so that the lock is in place, and I let go the compressor, the wax spring compressor. Today I'm going to do this side, the intake cam valve clearance. So I have this handy adjustable spanner. I'm going to locate the cam here, and then I've already tightened them, so I'm going to turn a few rounds and see whether it is free to move. Okay. Okay, but I'm going to check the first one and the fourth one first, since they are pointing up. Okay, I have my trusty feeler gauge, because I trust this one. So maybe I hope this one to be true, so that all my readings are correct. The valve clearance should be really low. Should be less than 0.3. Okay, let's try 0.2. 0.25. Oh, yes. Oh. This one can go through. Okay. I'm going to use slightly bigger 0.20. Alright.
Okay, guys, press the like button if you guys like this video, and share with your friends if you think this video will benefit them. Subscribe for more videos, and I will share more insights of 2JZ engine building. See you.